So what is an artist CV? That is what we're going to go over today, why it's important, and basically, you know, how to write a great artist CV that communicates exactly who you are as an artist. But make sure you like and subscribe and hit that bell notification so that you're notified whenever I do videos like this. Now let's get started. So an artist CV is basically a summary of the artist's history. Basically just tells someone who's reading it all about what that artist has done in the past. So artist CVs will be used by juries and selection committees and, you know, schools, residencies, museums, galleries, nonprofits, grants organizations, foundations, to really just go over and evaluate what creative or artist is best fit for a particular opportunity. Artist CV is only one, you know, of many factors, but it's a very important factor because it tells so much about an artist and sort of what they're capable of. When you have a stack of artist CVs and you're going through them, you know, you're really just looking at the history of that artist and figuring out, okay, what have they done? Where have they gone? Where are they at in their stage of their career? How dedicated are they in sort of their career or practice? Are they consistent, you know, year after year, or are there gaps? You know, what type of education do they have? Things like this. So it's really important that you have an artist CV and you work on your artist CV to better it and sort of make it more, sort of have more punch whenever it's in a pile, you know, being considered, because sometimes this can be the difference between an opportunity and not getting an opportunity. So the contents of an artist CV. So we're gonna go over that right now. And the first piece of content you need to have at the top is the header. So the header will have your name, your contact information, your date of birth, because sometimes people want to know when you were born and where you were born as well. So usually that's something that will be at the top. So right after that, there's the education section. And basically that's just showing exactly where you went to school, you know, what degree you get and when you graduated. So that just helps out in terms of figuring out, okay, what sort of background when it comes to the arts education did they have. And sometimes you don't have to put arts education. You know, I didn't get an art degree, so I usually just have my business degrees on there, but that's okay. So just having something on there to show them that, hey, you know, I'm sort of taking this serious, I got my education in some form or fashion, you know, that's always good. And if you didn't go to a university or a higher education, you can always sometimes put, you know, different certificates or degrees. I've seen that before, and that's totally fine with me personally. Or if you didn't go to school at all and basically you can just put your high school, you know, that's totally fine with me. You know, in the end, the work is sort of what matters. So that's something that I just want to sort of let you guys know so that you're not sort of intimidated about, you know, I didn't go to school or I didn't have an education, because everyone has different factors that factor into their life. So I don't count that against anyone. So that's something just to know. And right after that, I usually like to put the solo exhibition. So if you had solo exhibitions in your career, you want to make sure you list that as well. You want to make sure everything is in chronological order so that the earliest or the most recent is at the top, and it just goes down from there. So when I'm looking at it and I'm starting that section, I'm looking at the most sort of recent exhibition or solo exhibition in that section that you've had, and then the one after that, and then the one after that, and then one after that. When you're putting the solo exhibition, usually, you know, I put the year, the exhibition, the title, and then the locations. So after the solo exhibition, you can put the group exhibition. That's what I usually do. And that's really just putting all the group exhibitions that you participated in throughout your career. After the group exhibitions, usually you can interchange the order of things, but I'll have residencies. So what residencies did I attend throughout my career? After residencies, usually I will have like awards and grants and fellowships, you know, I've gotten throughout my career. So I'll have a list of that chronologically. And then after that, I'll add publications and press. Basically, what press did my shows get? What press did my work get or my practice get? Usually I'll put the most significant press in there and the most recent press in there as well. And lastly, what collections are you a part of? Were you collected by, you know, a major collection by a museum? Was it sort of, you know, a major collector that everyone sort of knows that sort of brings cachet? So what collections are your works a part of? So for me, after your solo and group exhibitions, the sections can be reordered however you want to. I usually don't have a big preference, but that's how I sort of usually order those sections in terms of the way I do my resume. In each section, I'll usually try to have the date so that it's easy to see exactly what is the most current. You know, is there a gap in between years? When did I start? When did I sort of like finish off? So I'll have the date on the left side, and then I'll have basically, you know, the content in the middle, you know, the press or the collection or the group show name, things like that, and in their respective sections. And then on the right side, I will have the location. So, you know, where was this exhibition? Where was this residency, if it mattered? And that is usually how I will sort of format things. So that is easy for someone to just read and sort of glance through, because if it's really jumbled up, it's going to be difficult to sort of have someone just glance at it and really sort of gain all that information, especially if it's long. And that's another thing, how long should an artist CV be? So I've seen some that are 1 to 2 pages. I've seen some that are 6 pages long. I'm not mad at really long sort of CVs as long as it's formatted correctly, because you have to think some artists are older, you know, 50s, 60s, 70s, and they have a long history. So they want to sort of talk about some of the things that they've done early on, and some of the things they have done early on throughout their career may be really significant. Versus someone who's just starting out may have a short CV, you know, you're trying to sort of pack it full of things. As long as things that are in there are relevant to that sort of situation, you know, I'm not mad at, you know, having a long resume that's easy to read. And I'm not mad at really short resumes, because, you know, your resume can be really, really long, but sometimes light in terms of, you know, the content, because it doesn't have sort of really significant stuff in there. And sometimes your resume can be really short. I've seen short resumes that have a lot of content in there because everything they put in there is really significant, stands out, is sort of gives them a lot of credibility. And when it comes to overall formatting, what your resume looks like in terms of like a PDF doc or just like the entire page, the formatting, you know, what should it look like? And that's really up to you. I just pulled up a resume that is super simple, black and white format, header at the top, has the education, solo shows, has the group shows, has the residencies, the year is on the left, whereas the content is in the middle, and then on the right, the location of basically where that sort of event happened or that activity happened. You know, if I had 5 pages of this, it wouldn't be a big problem. For me, this simple sort of, you know, plain cookie cutter CV for an artist is, you know, that's totally fine for me. And on the other side, you can get really jazzy with your CV as well. I recently saw formatting, I'm gonna pull this up right now, that was really cool. It had like the image on the left, it had like a short artist statement at the top, a statement about where this individual went to school, and then basically some of the press that she garnered throughout sort of her recent career. And basically below that, you know, the different sections were like the solo exhibitions, the awards and residencies, the group shows, and each of the entries that were included in those sections were great because they showed the diversity. It showed like the breadth of, you know, the work that this artist was doing. It showed, you know, really that they were dedicated to their craft and they were on the top of their game. And it was basically one page. So that just shows you're able to do something really jazzy in terms of formatting and keeping it to one page as you were to do something that's really plain and 6 pages long. For me, you know, I really like this new formatting that this artist did. So in the end, the artist CV is really about conveying a summary of the artist's sort of career and what they've done. So hopefully this video helped out in terms of just understanding the CV and how to format it and what to add in it, what to take out. I'll try to have a link to a template that you can sort of download so that you can sort of just build off of that. I love doing these videos. Make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you're notified whenever I do videos like this, because that really just helps me in terms of just being able to do this more and more and more, because the artist community really needs artists to sort of help other artists out, and that's what I'm trying to do. So like I said, like, subscribe, hit that bell notification, and I will see you next time. Peace.